coin is Caesar's image on it? What bears God's image? Jesus leaves this little two-part sermon here, and he gives us just the first part. And he invites us to think back to the book of Genesis, which teaches us that we are made in the image and likeness of God. So we see that this offering to God is really ourselves. When Jesus tells us to bring to God what belongs to God, he's asking us to offer our entire lives, all of our thoughts, our desires, particularly our loves. But if we look at ourselves, and we think of ourselves as this coin in the image of God, we might see that this coin is kind of dirty, perhaps it's a little bent, it's kind of misshapen, it's not a perfect image. And so the other part of what our Lord is teaching us is he's teaching us about himself. Jesus himself is the perfect image of God, as the Word is the perfect image of the Father. And as true man, a perfect human being, he's the one who's made perfectly in the image and likeness of God. But Jesus does not give himself to us merely as a model. He's not just a shiny coin in a museum case that we look at and admire and maybe try to polish ourselves up. But he comes to us, especially here in the universe. He comes to us and he makes us more like himself. So in our seeking to offer ourselves to God as a coin made in his image, we can trust that God himself